and I wanted to talk to Arnie and David, the Diaz duo with Waterstone Mortgage. We talked a little bit before the first segment of the show. We were talking homestead exemption. We also talked about assessments and differentiation between value. If you missed that, make sure to check us out on our social channels. We'll put the video up after the show. And we're at the Duncan Duo on Instagram and YouTube and Facebook, and then on Twitter as well. So make sure to check us out. We'll put that video up. So if you have property tax questions, and we'll make sure to send that out to all of our social media channels. But you guys, we were talking before about, you know, how property taxes can affect debt to income and you know, qualifying for a mortgage. We see that a lot, where I think sometimes people misinterpret, misunderstand, or, you know, not quite clear on how the property tax estimate you guys use to qualify someone is. So I thought that'd be a good conversation for, you know, how to navigate around that for a consumer, from a consumer's perspective.
It happens a lot. I mean, basically, when a client comes to us to try to get pre-qualified for something, we're not sure what home they're interested in. Like Bob mentioned, even homes in the same neighborhood can have widely different tax bills. So it's important to know that these can vary quite a bit. So basically, what happens when you find a home, you know, we're going to estimate it based on your the price range that you're looking at in the beginning. But once you find a property that you're interested in, we're going to go to the Hillsborough County Property Appraiser website, which actually, compared to other counties, is actually quite nice to use.
I mean, it's hcpafl.org. Correct. I have that memorized because I type it.
You go to it all the time.
So, I see Bob's face just like 38,000 times a year.
It's nice to meet you.
Maybe I'll put Kevin Kiermaier's face up
there. I thought you were going to say you were going to put Arnie's face up
there.
I'm trying to get reelected here.
Good move. So basically, we will go to that website and we will pull up the actual tax bill for the current owner. And so how we, basically in mortgage world, we're going to take the current owner's tax bill, and that's going to be the new purchaser's tax bill for the, till the rest of the year. And then basically, hopefully, I mean, if this is a homestead property, hopefully you do remember to file your homestead exemption and do it on time, of course.
I actually had a customer I talked to yesterday that he actually is in a condo. He wants to buy a bigger condo in the same complex. Mm-hmm. And his taxes are $2,000 a year, and he couldn't believe that this other condo he was looking at was $4,500. Of course, it didn't have homestead. So he was asking me, this is like perfect timing, because he's asking me all these questions about, can I move my homestead over? And I go, yeah. Let me look that up.
One of the things I think is important about that same line of question, David, is that that tax bill that you guys you know, adjust in your payment for is going to be the tax bill for the rest of that year. But obviously, with a new owner, that tax bill is going to assess, and it's going to change. We get those calls, the freak out calls, like, my property, my mortgage cost just went up all this amount. Because either the prior owner had a homestead on it or some other exemption, and then that came off, or, you know, it just gets reassessed because that person had owned it for a long time.
Exactly. It's one of the things that we constantly talk about. You know, we can see if the current owner has a homestead. Or if the current owner doesn't, we can say, hey, the potential that your taxes are going to go down. So it depends on the situation.
A lot of times those freak out calls happen because they forget to file their homestead exemption.
Right.
And then their property tax goes up markedly more than they
thought it would. Or if they buy a new construction home, because a lot of times.
Oh, yeah, they're taxed on land in the first year.
Taxed on land in the first year, right. Yes.
And so those are some I wouldn't say loopholes, but those are some things you want to pay attention to. You know, when you're buying, if your tax bill goes up dramatically, did you remember to file your exemption? And if you're buying a new construction home, your payment until it's reassessed at the actual house cost is going to be artificially low for a period of time. So you got to make sure to budget in that you can afford that.
Well, and a couple of things along those lines. We have a tax estimator on the website that's enhanced somewhat from the old.
It is way better. It is way better than the old one. The old one was so clunky.
So that's something that people can try to use as well. And also, if you're buying, a lot of folks are building new homes, or you see a lot of infill development going on where, you know, people are tearing down homes and rebuilding, particularly in South Tampa or in some areas, Seminole Heights, and what have you. You also should look at the date of completion, and when you're actually going to move in, and your CO. And that's, it's the law, by law, when it's, quote, substantially complete is when it goes on the website, on the tax roll. But that actually generally means with a residential property, when somebody moves in or has their CO, if that home is going to be done on December 28th of a particular year, and you can, you know, wait and move in on January 2nd,
then you're in pretty good shape.
Moving on January 2nd.
No, that's a good reminder for us to talk about on our, towards the end of the year, to have you on again to talk about that at the end of the year, because I think that's a good point for anyone building a home.